Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. It's nice to be here today.
Sup?
So we are back today with another reaction to Sabaton. Today it's gonna be No Bullets Fly. So without further ado, let's go check it out.
Samuel?
It's December the 20th, 1943, and in the freezing air, high above Germany, Second Lieutenant Charles Charlie Brown is at the controls of his B-17F, ye old pub. At 11:30, approaching the target of the Focke Wulf plant near Bremen, the pub is rocked as four explosions go off right in front of the B-17. A cry comes across the intercom.
We're hit.
In the plexiglass nose, a huge hole had been made. An icy cold wind was being blown inside, making freezing conditions for the crew. Engine 2 had been hit, and co-pilot Spencer Pinky Luke let out an expletive as he noticed a huge hole in the right wing. Releasing their bombs over the factory, the crew turned to the north, planning to head over the coast, then turn west for home. With one engine out, and engine 4 now faulty, the pub started to fall back from the formation with another damaged plane.
Can you imagine
Sam
being there?
Blackie Blackford in the ball turret watched as it disappeared into a cloud bank.
Wow.
There was an orange flash in the cloud. Bandits, Eki shouted, as five BF-109s streaked from the cloud bank. Then another cry. Bandits, as eight FW-190s were spotted in formation ahead of the pub. Sergeant Bertrand Frenchy Coulomb in the turret shot the 190 out of the sky. The navigator, Al Doc Sadek, took out the second. Pinky reported that engine 3 had been hit. That left just one engine at full power. The BF-109s attacked the pub from behind, swarming all over. But due to the cold wind running through the pub, most of the guns were frozen.
Wow.
In a turn now,
that's crazy.
The pub was repeatedly hit, taking extreme damage and killing the tail gunner.
Sure.
A shell penetrated and exploded near the waist gunners, injuring the crew and creating a huge hole. The oxygen supply was taken out and the pub spun towards the ground. With the crew unconscious due to lack of oxygen, the B-17 fell for 4 miles. Charlie started to come around and grabbed the controls, pulling back as the
plane
continued
to fall. Sounds like crazy, man.
5,000 feet, 4,000 feet, 3,000 feet. Just moments from hitting the earth, the plane pulled up, almost scraping the trees as it did.
Wow.
I like the logo. Really cool logo. Cool melodies.
That voice again.
That's true. That's cool.
Wow.
Whoa. Wow, so cool, man.
Yeah.
Anti-air guns.
Mm-hmm.
the old pub. I love the name, actually.
Wow.
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 Okay. Their friends are back.
The story was kept secret until 1986, when Brown started the search for the German pilot who had shown mercy on that December day all those years ago. In 1990, Brown received a letter from a man named Stigler, who was living in Canada. Stigler explained that he had been the pilot of the German fighter who had escorted Ye Olde Pub. This video is of their first meeting.
Franz, what were your feelings when you met again for the first time?
I was so happy as we met that I dropped him.
Wow.
How about him? Was it easy?
Wow.
The fact that he risked his life, really, in many ways, and I wrote him in a letter, I said, if you made a habit of feeling sorry for bomber crews flying up alongside them, I am sure that you were shot down many times. But it was not only the audacity that he came up to us and then recognizing the threat. If someone had seen him and reported him, it could have been a death sentence.
Franz gifted Charlie a book, and inside the inscription read, "In 1940, I lost my only brother as a night fighter. On the 20th of December, 4 days before Christmas, I had the chance to save a B-17 from her destruction. A plane so badly damaged, it was a wonder that she was still flying. The pilot, Charlie Brown, is for me as precious as my brother was. Thanks, Charlie. Your brother, Franz." In 2008, within a few months of each other, the two firm friends went on their final journey. Franz Stigler never got the Knight's Cross, but as he always said, he got something better.
Hi, my name is Jovita Tan Stiegler. I would like to thank Sabaton and your song, No Bullets Fly. Because of this, the story of my father will live on. See you on your next concert tour. Safe journey, gentlemen, and again, thank you.
Wow, that's so cool.
Wow.
And they did.
Is it a band?
No, they did. They attended the concert.
Wow.
Oh my God, this is so amazing. This is, you know, I really appreciate what these guys do, Sabaton. After I watched the first videos of Christmas Truce, it was unexpected how I came across this band, Sabaton. I really can't even remember, you know, but I'm glad I did, because getting to watch them and from all the stories, from the comments and everything, we've got to know that they're really doing a very good job with history, telling us more about our histories. I'm always very interested when it comes to like history, you know, learning about our histories and everything. And with everything, I just enjoy their music. It's not just music, it's a life lesson, like something, giving out something. You know, I really appreciate what they do. Other than even I know I enjoyed your music a lot. That voice, the, you know, the instruments and everything, so cool, so unique. And then, you know, to put a cherry at the top, the whole story behind it is very interesting, very catchy, very, you wouldn't want to miss out on anything, you know. It's really amazing. I really appreciate them.
Yeah, it was amazing. It's first time I ever heard about this story.
Yeah.
And it's cool that it's coming through like a Sabaton, like a music, you know, video, a band that, you know, decided to do a song based on the story. And actually, you know, the whole animation, I liked the whole intro that explained the situation. Then you had the song that was kind of telling the part of the story. And then the end where they, you know, explained a little bit more about the pilot who escorted them and, you know, showed the videos of how they met and the mom of the gentleman also was, you know, shown. And then they kind of actually met. So, wow, it's cool.
Wow.
The story is like crazy. I wouldn't be able to imagine, you know, being there. It's really, we live in a different times. And if you try and think and realize how it was during the war, Second World War, like, it feels surreal, you know? You watch movies, you kind of watch history videos on it, and, you know, I still think it's hard to actually realize how crazy it was. And, wow, the story is amazing. Like, it's really, really unbelievable, you know? I love the video.
I do. That's too. Cool. Totally. Wow. Thanks, guys, for checking out this video with us. We'll be back with lots of Sabaton reactions, you know, to their videos. And please stay subscribed. If you're not subscribed to our channel, consider subscribing as well. And give us a thumbs up if you like this video. Keep the suggestions coming and the comments. And we'll see you all in our next video. Until then, it's bye from me.
See you later.